I'm the Alchemist Astrologer, and this is your Sun, Moon, and Stars reading for Aquarius Sun, Aquarius Rising, and Aquarius Moon. So the Sun row represents the outward appearance. It's the manifestation of a situation and how the world sees it. You have the Ace of Cups. So this is about love and happiness. Maybe it's the start of a relationship. Maybe it's a new direction in an ongoing relationship. It could be gifts of love. It could be connection to spirit, divine source, inspiration, a creative project, something that is a new beginning for you emotionally, something that brings you a sense of peace. For some of you, this is about a consuming passion that you have. Again, maybe it's a person, maybe it's a project, an endeavor of some sort. There are issues of intimacy here. And something is stirring your heart. It's pulling your heartstrings. Maybe there's emotional renewal as a part of this process. And again, that could be because you're falling in love or you're reviving a relationship. Maybe you're getting married. Maybe you're having a child. Whatever it is, it's going to be nearly impossible for you not to keep your feelings to yourself. Your cup is running over. And you're going to want to share how you feel with others. So for some of you, you may either receive or send out a proposal. This could be a proposal of marriage. It could be a strong I love you. Maybe you're renewing your vows. Could be a gift, some kind of surprise, a romantic gesture. And again, you may be a willing victim of love and all that goes with it. So for some of you, this is the start of a new situation emotionally. And, you know, again, it's making you feel emotionally fulfilled. Now, negatively, maybe there's some moodiness. Maybe there's a fear of love, or somebody is failing to initiate the relationship that they want, or they're failing to take it in the desired direction. It could be that somebody's backtracking. Maybe somebody moved too quickly toward love before they were ready, or perhaps there's unrequited love. There's a rejection here. So some of you may be dealing with a broken heart, and maybe that's because you felt like your emotions were being toyed with, or there's some kind of delay in getting a relationship off the ground, and you may feel loneliness because of that. Maybe it's the end of an affair, or there's some kind of separation, or the relationship you're in doesn't offer you emotional fulfillment. So for some of you, you may end up saying something, but it may turn into a bitter or hurtful quarrel, and possibly because you feel overwhelmed emotionally. But some of you may be sharing your feelings with someone that you feel very enchanted with, or you're receiving that, or you're sharing your feelings about something that you want. You want to bring some ideas you have to life. Again, this could be a creative pursuit, or maybe you want to attract into your life what you desire. Maybe you're trying to influence others. But for some of you, you're under an illusion. You're feeling, again, emotionally overwhelmed. Maybe you're enchanted by something that's not possible, or you're not doing what is necessary to achieve or manifest that. And so you need to take some steps. Now, the Moon row is your inward manifestation. This is how this situation makes you feel. And it's the effect that it's having on you as a person. So you have the Hanged Man here. So you may feel like you're just hanging in limbo, that things are moving agonizingly slow. There's something you feel strongly emotionally about. You want this new beginning in an emotional area of your life. There's something you're very enchanted with, and you're having to wait for it. Maybe you're willing to wait. Maybe whatever this is calls for sacrifice, and you're willing to make that necessary sacrifice. So you may be selflessly dedicating yourself to some kind of goal. This is a card that indicates withdrawal from the material world to focus on the spiritual side of self, to gain some kind of enlightenment. So you may be withdrawing in order to meditate. Maybe you're walking a different path. Maybe, you know, you're not traditional. Maybe you're off the beaten path. So you may be doing something, you dare to be different. Maybe you're a spiritual person. Maybe, you know, you are learning some kind of lesson. You're taking your time with something. And perhaps this calls for some spiritual attunement. Your commitment, your flexibility to the current circumstance, the ability to adapt to others. So you may be making a readjustment. It could be, again, a voluntary sacrifice because you know that something higher and is at stake here. But there is a standstill, and you may have to let go of certain things. Maybe this is because there's been an unexpected domestic or career change. Perhaps you're having to surrender to the opposing viewpoint. So you shared your feelings and now you're waiting for the response, or somebody is opposed to what you've shared. So you may be changing your mind about something, or someone may be trying to change your mind. But a new perspective is called for. So the action has slowed down so that people can gather this new information, this new set of circumstances. The action has slowed. And this can feel like a testing period because there are lessons to be learned. You are meant to tap into your intuition. You're connecting with divine. This is cosmic consciousness in order to gain enlightenment. So you may be taking a fresh approach to a situation. Maybe, you know, something is being given back. This can be a reversal where something was, you know, one way, now it's being given back to someone, or the tide is turning. Now, negatively, this is a martyr for, you know, no good reason. Sacrifice, doormat, walk all over me. It's somebody who really doesn't know clearly who they are, and they tend to define themselves in the terms or the wishes of other people. There's a lack of commitment, perhaps, to something, to someone, to self, to others, that could easily turn into selfishness if you're not careful. Because this can be a card of, it's ruled by Neptune. Neptune rules muddled thinking, uncertainty, being vague, being deceptive, falling susceptible to addictions like drugs or alcohol. So it's important that you do take a time out to get clear about, you know, what kind of sacrifice is necessary, whether you're willing to make it, whether you're involved in something that's giving you a false sense of security, whether you've made a bad investment or some poor financial decisions, the dissatisfaction you feel, whether you're being true to yourself or you're participating in something that is killing you on a soul level. So it could be a refusal to break with the past and past habits. Maybe you're denying an important part of yourself. For some of you, you know, this may be a different path, maybe alternative lifestyle, alternative ways of loving. Maybe you are dealing with issues of sexuality. For some of you, this is about, again, promises not being kept, unrealized projects, unrealized objectives, unjust accusations. You're trapped in a situation, for all intents and purposes, imprisoned in some way. So you may have all of these emotions, feeling as if you're just hanging around, you're in limbo, things are not moving. Maybe you're dealing with unwelcome situations or people, or you feel stuck, or again, you feel very dedicated to something. It's important that you remain objective, whatever's going on, that you see yourself clearly and you see others, that you're realistic. Because a new perspective about whatever has gone on in the past is going to help you make sense now, in the here and now, so that you can put the past aside and deal with it, make peace with it, and reevaluate goals based on what's happened in the past so that you can do better. This is meeting the future with greater clarity. But it is going to take your patience, some hard effort, some perseverance to stay focused on what the ultimate goal is. This is about being realistic in order to achieve a goal. And so it requires that you maintain your equilibrium, your sense of peace of mind, in spite of whatever's happening around you. Remaining tranquil and even is going to help you see things clearly. You can't allow yourself to be broken by the past or challenges or setbacks. And you also have to live in your own truth. If people are trying to play the guilt card and make you feel like you should have or you don't deserve, or you have to break through that fog and see the truth of yourself. And that may mean valuing yourself, loving yourself, not buying into the suggestions, the innuendos, the messages that others are sending you. So this is a time where you're likely to make some self-sacrifice, but you have to look at that to see if you're actually accomplishing something, something of value. If you have some doubt about yourself, your own self-worth, your self-value, your actions, you're likely to do what comes easiest, what you've always done, whether it's good for you or the situation. And this is a time for being clear, because if you're trying to stuff your feelings, your emotions down, your resentment, your frustration, it's just going to pop up somewhere else. Eventually, you may end up taking it out on people or situations that don't actually deserve it. So this is a time you're in limbo for a reason, to look at something clearly, to gain some spiritual enlightenment about how you can do something differently, how you can do it better. Because every time you turn away from a loose end, something that you need to tend to, eventually it's going to come up somewhere else in your life. So you may want to take better steps, move in a new direction, but you may fall back on bad habits because you don't address what needs to. You have some self-limiting habits, some self-limiting attitudes. And so this is a time where your composure is going to be challenged. How objective can you remain in spite of changing circumstances? Now, this may have to do with the future or money. Maybe you're waiting on money. Maybe you're waiting on something for the future. Maybe you've changed your mind about something. Maybe something that you gave up is going to come back to you. This is about good fortune, manifesting something with your thoughts, going within to be clear on the vision in order to produce it tangibly. So there's some possibilities, or again, you're waiting around. You need to get some clarity about a situation. Now, the last row is the stars row, the way you can make this situation work for you. You have the Ten of Swords. Now, I know a lot of people don't like this card, but this is how you can make a situation work for you. You may have felt victimized, and perhaps you were. For some of you, maybe this is about being in the hospital. Maybe you're dealing with a serious illness, or maybe you need to address a serious illness. Maybe you're having back issues or surgery, or you've had a near-death experience. Maybe you have felt pinned to a circumstance, as if you can't get up, you feel down and out. So some of you have bottomed out. But the way you can make this situation work for you is to overcome a victim mentality, because you could very well be at the end of a cycle. Do not accept personal defeat. Do not accept failure as your lot. It may be time to let go of something. If you've been ill, maybe it's time to do some investigation about what is troubling you physically or emotionally. Maybe it's time to separate. Maybe it's time to get a divorce. Maybe it's time to close something out. It's time to bring an end to a situation in order to set the groundwork for a new beginning. And in fact, the worst could be over. You may be recovering and in rebirth mode. You want to relieve yourself from stress. You've survived some terrible situations. You may need to turn to a higher power. This is about getting past difficulties and dealing with some chronic, long, drawn-out problems. For some of you, this may feel like, you know, things are moving so quickly that you need some rest, or that nothing is moving at all. So you feel like you're carrying the weight of the world on your shoulder, that all the responsibilities are bearing down on you. But again, keep in mind that the clouds are clearing. And this means that you got to get your attitude back on track. You got to get your perspective in order. You got to see things differently. Go at it from a new angle. Take a fresh approach. And again, you can't deny your duties, your responsibilities, your obligations. You got to deal with them because they're going to catch up with you anyway. So this is actually giving you a second look at a situation, something that had gone wrong, something that had some flaws, and now you get an opportunity. It seems like a challenge. It is a challenge, but it's also an opportunity to recognize what you didn't see before and make it better. Now you can follow a more resourceful course of action that's going to allow you to succeed and go even further than you had originally planned. Your expectations may be surpassed. So this is a time to pick yourself up, dust yourself off, pull those knives out of your back, and keep stepping. You've got a goal. You've got something you've got to accomplish, a mission. Don't get caught up. So you're going to have to work hard to rejuvenate yourself, to remember what that goal is, but keep your eye on the prize. Keep that sense of purpose. Don't assume that everything is over, it's lost, and you're going to start closing doors and burning bridges just because you had a few hiccups. This is about putting an end to negative situations and negative habits and moving forward. Bring an end to something so that you can figure out what the direction is. And that may mean focusing, being motivated, having drive. You need to create a plan and you need to follow through with it, because, you know, what gets you in trouble is being aimless, needing to reorient yourself. So this is about moving forward or moving onward. Now, the underlying energy is this King of Wands. This is fire energy. So that may be, somebody may be important who is an Aries, a Leo, a Sagittarius, but the traits mean that somebody is taking charge of a situation. This is a natural born leader. He does not lack confidence. He's a straight shooter. He is not playing games. He knows what he wants. His ambitions are clear. He holds them firmly in his hands, and he's going after it. So there's no second guessing here. This is somebody who's not afraid. They're not afraid of the fire. They're seeking adventure. So for some of you, the passion, the drive, the motivation to get up and take charge of a situation is going to be important. Now, this person also, though, because he's so gung-ho, he has difficulty sometimes knowing the right things to say. He can put his foot in his mouth. He's clever, he's magnetic, but every now and again, he can say the wrong thing that takes a situation off track. You may be doing that, or you may be drawn to somebody. You may find somebody very attractive. Maybe you suddenly develop an attraction for somebody, and you're going out of your way to get their attention, or vice versa. You know, this is somebody who's got a lot of potential. They know what their value is, and they attract people and opportunity like bees and honey. Now, depending on his inclination, he may be faithful to his partner, or he may be subject to respond to some kind of under the table opportunity, a discreet invitation, a liaison. In fact, he's the most capable of the kings of maintaining, you know, his side thing as well as his primary relationship. So he may be prone to a number of successive affairs. You know, he it may be hard to tie him down and tie him to commitment, because he's a bit of a commitment phobic. And he can be very authoritarian. He wants relationships on his terms. He sees the world in his terms. It's black and white. And he has a tendency, because of that passion and drive, to go overboard. And he can put himself at risk as far as his health, as far as financially, the decisions that he makes. And worse than that, he can also put those closest to him at risk. So he's a gambler. He gambles with love. He gambles with money. Now, negatively, maybe this is a misogynist. You've had to make a sacrifice. There's been some betrayal where you were, you know, being loving. And this is somebody who may not have been worthy of that. Again, a misogynist, demanding, using their personal power for personal gain, not taking responsibility, blaming other people, not being accountable for what's happened in the relationship. So there could be some power struggles where it's blocking love. There's a lack of personal responsibility, in which case, this, if this is an attraction or was, it's probably going to burn out. Now, it could be that you feel bottomed out because you've been trying to share your love or trying to make sacrifice, and you're not really getting anywhere with it. So eventually this burns out. But you do have the card of renewal. So you are taking charge of a situation. This may be to renew some passion, endeavor, relationship. There's a new beginning, some revitalization that may connect to healing, healing physically, emotionally, financially. And it means that you need to encourage a positive mindset, either in yourself or perhaps motivating others. Now, the advice is discernment, the waxing gibbous moon. So let's see what that is all about. Discernment. Take care in your choices now. Look carefully and judge wisely. There may have been something difficult to see, something that has been obscured, but now it has been revealed to you. Examine it closely. I take my time to be accurate and precise in my discernment. When you get some years on you, hopefully the time you spend moving and choosing upon this earth brings you some kind of wisdom. Some of that wisdom will be bred of hindsight and perspective. All of us, if we are engaged in life, make good decisions and poor ones. Sometimes we make spectacularly bad ones. All of us get hurt, hurt others, learn, forget, fall over again, get up. But hopefully we grow, we change. We're able to spot where our sore spots are and fix them if we so choose. We're able to take a good long look at what is painfully recurring in our lives and deal with it. Yes, baby, deal. The secret here is discernment, real discernment, really making it a priority to take time to ensure acuteness of judgment, really looking at the fine print before you buy. Instead of taking things on face value or rushing into surface judgments, take your sweet time to form friendships and business relationships. Put your energy output into perspective, looking at evidence instead of only just believing. Feel and act when you are being trodden upon or having your boundaries overstepped or when something doesn't quite feel kosher. Ask clarifying questions and really listen to the answers offered. Then act on the reality. That is growth. That is real pattern busting. That is the gathering of wisdom. Note the waxing gibbous moon. This is the first of the waxing gibbous moons. The overall themes of this part of the moon cycle are action and will. So that ties nicely into tapping into your intuition, connecting with spirit, really looking at things clearly, not what you believe them to be, not deceiving yourself or allowing yourself to be deceived by others, really looking closely, taking your time, especially in issues where, you know, there's the potential for betrayal or there has been betrayal. You're not stuck. You can move forward, but you need to use discernment. Take charge to bring about your own personal renewal. All right, Aquarius, I hope you enjoyed this reading. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the notify bell button, and leave me some comments.